Hello once again, camper friends. This is Jim, the director at Running Brook Day Camp, coming to you for another episode of RBC-TV. I hope your weekend is off to a great start, and I hope those of you that had school vacation week last week had a really wonderful week. I hope you got outside, maybe got to see some friends, got to play outside with family and to be active. Today I'm coming to you on a bit of a dreary, rainy day, but guess what, my friends? Summer 2021 at Running Brook is now only 58 days away. We cannot wait to be together with you all out in the warm summer sun, playing together and having a great time, a great experience together. Now, a big email went out to all of your parents and guardians about a week or so ago. There was a lot of really important updates for everyone to know about this summer. I wanted to share a few of the key ones with all of you today. So here we go. The first big update I wanted to share with all of you campers is about swimming at camp. Now, every summer, swimming is one of the most favorite activities for lots and lots of our campers. We are going to be swimming a whole bunch at camp this summer, but because we can't have quite as many groups at the pools at one time like we usually do, and also because we can't wear our masks while we're swimming in the pool, of course, we have to have fewer kids in the pools at one time. So what does that mean? Well, what it's looking like is that every camper group is going to be able to go swimming about every other day at camp. So somewhere between maybe 5 and 7 periods of swimming in a 2-week session. Now, I know that's not ideal. We'd all love to be in the pools every day of the summer, but because we have so many campers and lots of friends at camp that we want everybody to have the chance to have a swim lesson and some free swim time, we got to break everything down as far as the overall numbers. So not everybody's going to get to swim every single day. However, we are going to mix in all kinds of water games and sprinkler time and other ways to kind of stay cooled off, especially on the days when we're not scheduled to be at the pools. So that's a really important update for you all. Now, speaking of that, parents, those of you that have completed all your forms, good job. Kudos to you. We do still have a bunch of families who haven't completed all their forms, and that's really important. One of those forms is about swimming. We ask you for some of your input on your camper's swim ability or swim level that you know of. That'll really help us put a good tight schedule together before we even get to camp together. So all your help with that is greatly appreciated. So please hop on those forms as soon as you can. The second big update from that email last week, we had to make a really hard decision within the last couple of weeks at camp, and that is we had to cancel our extended day program. Now, that was a real bummer because we know extended day is lots of fun for kids who stay a little bit after camp or who come early in the morning if their parents or guardians are working. And families, we also know it's a bit of a burden to not be able to offer that service to you all. The reason is, I want campers to understand, is we're going to be following guidelines at camp this summer that help keep everybody in our community really safe. And the biggest one that we follow this summer is that when we're at camp together during the day, we're going to be in our camper groups with our counselors, and that's what we call a cohort. And this summer at camp, we won't be mixing cohorts. In other words, we won't be having campers from different groups kind of mixing together during camp. And so extended day, that's how it's normally set up, right? It's kids from all different groups that mix together. And so in order to do that safely and to have enough staff to kind of make it work was just not going to work this summer. And so we had to make that decision to cancel. Now, one thing I've been trying to do a lot, well, first of all, I wanted to share this with you guys. This is pretty cool, right? This is some slime that belongs to my daughter, Jocelyn, who I think most of you have gotten to meet in some of these earlier episodes. So this is some pretty cool slime that she has. And I was using this today and I was thinking, this is a really great symbol for camp this summer, right? Because it's super fun. It's super silly. I can get really creative with it, but it's also, it's really flexible, right? And that's one of the things we're already talking a lot about camp this summer, is that we all need to be a little bit more flexible than we usually are, maybe, because things at camp just can't quite be the same as they normally are. But you know what? That's okay, because the main ingredients that make camp so special and wonderful will definitely be there. And that's first and foremost all of you campers, plus all our wonderful staff mixed together, and it makes this incredible, fun, creative, silly, flexible community, and we're going to have an awesome time together. So we're trying not to focus too much on the things that we can't quite do the same that we normally do, or the things that have to be a little bit different, because there's so much good about camp that's still going to be the same. So we're going to keep our focus there. Okay. Now, related to that, parents and guardians, we sent a reminder. We're going to send you some more communications. We have a really special event coming up on Wednesday, May 19th from 7 to 8 p.m. A very special friend of ours, his name is Bob Ditter. He's going to do a special presentation just for Running Brook families, for parents and guardians, where we're going to get the chance to talk together about what this past year has been like for all of us, and particularly for our campers. And what does it mean, and how do we prepare to come back to camp together? It's going to be a really wonderful opportunity for all of you. So please join us. You've already gotten one email to sign up and to register. We will be sending a couple more, but please mark your calendars. We really hope you can all make it. It's a free event. Again, it's just for Running Brook parents and guardians, and it's going to be really worth your while. I can promise you that. Now, one other thing I wanted to mention to campers. We're seeing some changes in some of the guidelines that are out there as far as masks and things like that. We hope that things continue to improve in our communities, but I wanted to make sure you all understand this summer at camp, we are still going to all be wearing our masks, campers and staff. As I mentioned, we're going to stay in our cohorts throughout the day, every day at camp. We're not going to be mixing our cohorts. We're still going to be distancing, okay? We know it's safer to give a little space between us and our friends. We're going to be doing most of camp outside this summer. And by the way, that does include rainy days like today, okay? So if it's a little bit rainy outside and we're at camp together, we're going to be dressed for the weather and we're going to still be playing outside because we know it's safer to play outside together, okay? So I wanted to make sure you all were aware of that. Those things are still going to be in place this summer at camp, okay? And it's going to be really, really fun. All right, here we go. Special treat for you all today. We have a few of our wonderful specialists who want to say hi and introduce themselves to you. We have Zach, our woodshop specialist, and we have Jen, our music specialist. They are here to say hello and share some stuff with you. So enjoy.
Hi, everybody. Woodshop Zack here. I'm your woodworking instructor at Running Brook. And here I also have my assistant, Miss Tilly. And we have a little joke for you today. And the joke is, who do cats call when they are in trouble? Claw enforcement. Okay, I'm going to let it go now. Anyway, really looking forward to this summer. Making a lot of cool things. I've been already planning some projects and looking forward to meeting you all.
Hi. Hi, friends. I'm Music Jen. This is Ruthie. We've been coming to camp for many years. We just wanted to say hi and tell you a little bit about ourselves and share a song with you. One thing I enjoy outside of camp is running, and I'm hoping to run the Boston Marathon in the fall. My favorite food is tacos, and so I'm so happy when we have Taco Tuesday at camp. It's like my favorite thing ever. Fun fact about me, I have 4 cats. And the thing I'm looking forward to most about camp is community. That's not something I've really missed this past year, is getting together with friends and like-minded people. So I'm very excited about the community at camp.
So I like cats a lot. That's why we have 4 of them. Outside of camp, I play softball. I really like to have virtual play dates. I sing and I play percussion outside of camp as well. And my favorite color is blue, so I have a blue shirt on. I wear blue a lot. And one thing I'm really excited to do at camp is swim. I'm really looking forward to swimming in the pool. So, yeah.
I'm going to sing a song for you. It's called Tango. It's an echo song, so I'll sing and Ruthie's going to be my echo. This is a song we often do when we have Aqua Day or Luau Day. It's a Polynesian canoeing song. The people would sing it to keep their canoe paddles in rhythm with each other and stay together.
It's a really good song, so we're going to sing for you.
Tongo,
tongo,
chimney by my.
Tongo,
tongo, Malika all the way.
Malika all the way.
Ooh, all the way.
Ooh, all the way.
Malika all the way.
Malika all the way.
Bye, friends.
Bye.
See you at camp.
Summer.
I hope you all enjoyed those great videos from some of our specialists. Keep an eye out for future episodes. You're going to get the chance to see and meet more of our wonderful staff as we get closer to the start of camp together. And don't forget, campers and parents and guardians, if you have any questions for us about camp this summer, please submit them. RBC/TV. There's a page on our website. There's a form there on the side. That's where you can submit all your camper questions or parent and guardian questions as well, of course. Remember, May 19th, please mark your calendar, 7 to 8 p.m. With our friend Bob Ditter. It will be well worth your while. We hope to see you there. I will see you next week for another episode of Running Brook TV. Have a great week, everybody.